So, part 10 of this episode, of this series, rather. So, we set up most of the initial domain transitions that are needed to just log in to a graphical interface. And let's see what our next steps should be. Let's just do some basics here. Let's see if we are clean currently. I'll search MABCTS recent. And we actually aren't clean. Let's add it to allow this. So there's a bunch of stuff here that we need to allow. Let's make that 7 o'clock in the morning. Yeah. So we'll just append that. To my XDM. This is XDM running some of our confined applications. So there's still work to be done. All right. My XDM that's listed. This module is just a full list that basically just allows XDM and XDM derived domains to execute our confined application domain types, application executable file types, so to speak. Let's my login user type enforcement file. So this is our module currently. Yeah. So are we clear at least now after? Yeah, so we are at least clear now. Let's have a look at run user. And I'm just not seeing a directory for our my living user. Not sure whether that is instantiation or whether it's just not there. LS home my login user. This is full of crap already. So here we have our home directory. And let's just clear that. And we're going to basically have to be clearing this a lot. So I might just create a script right now that just does that. So nano clear my login user shell. I'll just copy this over. Paste that in, at least for now. So we have a bin bash. Bin shell. And then it's just basically rmrf home my login user. And then config. Then just because we basically need to see everything get created. Documents, downloads. ESD out. ESD out. GTK bookmarks. GTK bookmarks. ICE authority local. So basically that we run that script that it just cleans up this mess. We had local, so now we're at music. Pictures. Public. Now, with regard to transitions in a home directory, we really need to basically cooperate as much as possible with our upstream policy, else we'll get into conflicts. Templates, videos. Right. Let's remove this crap. So that all should clear up our home directory. And let's just LSR. And this might also be instantiated. Oh no, it's not. So I'll just copy this over as well. seems to be only RM or RF temp and then ESD 1012. That's the user ID. And then as for tools, that's a little bit problematic. Then I would have to basically script a lot of stuff to get that done. So that's basically something that I'll just have to ignore for now. LS all for temp, which is not used by the user, I think. No, this just color D and system D private. Could have a look at one of them. These are these private temps. It's instantiated. All right, no, anyways, it doesn't really, really matter anyways. So I'll just ls and then tmod plus x might clear my login user. And then just hope that it doesn't basically do anything wrong. All right, sure. Once more, I'll search ACTS recent. We're clear. So let's just log in. And less. Oops, yeah. We need to less. So basically, let's just grab XDM. Basically, we're still now having issues with XDM. It seems rather strange. We really need to deal with this stuff. It's weird though. Because I actually believe, just have a look at the policy, what happens here. As he search, ASCT, source, XDM, dbus, dt, and let's just see what happens with, that's actually strange, tbinty. Yeah, it's transitioning back. So what we need to do is basically edit some of this policy. First let's just try it out. Require. And then attribute exact type and then type transition XDM dbusd t and then exact type and then process transition to XDMT. Now this is not going to work. We really need to specify this. Actually, let's just do it this way. Require application executable file. This is an attribute. And then change exec type to application executable file. We just really need to take care of this. And then everything that has execute notons for XDM DBSD needs to be removed. So there was an execute notons there. We remove, oh no, we don't. These are two our execute notrans. And we actually want to transition. This is also an execute node trans. This is DDM XDM itself. XDM itself. We have two XDM node trans. Same here. Same here. Same here. And this is XDM itself. This is an XDM, this is node trans for XDM DBSD. Here we have a lot of stuff, and that should be allowed. Same for this stuff. And then we have some execute node trans here, which you can remove. Let's see where this gets us. So basically we just need to take care of this stuff first. We have an error, syntax error on line 4. For let's see. Less my login user T. It's very early, so I'm a little bit need to get going first. Application exec type, it's actually application exec type. Basically the point is that we want XDM to actually run these, or XDM DBSD actually run these programs in the XDM domain. Line 164. Instead of in the XDM DBS domain, that's why we're getting these errors. And then type application exec type. Damn. And turns out we can transition on a attribute. Are you kidding me? Yeah, and that makes sense, of course. Although it doesn't really make sense. So we're going to have to deal with that. So now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to grab this file for XDM and execute. Got grab XDM dbus dt and then grab execute. So all these types need to be required. I'll just make a note here, or need to be required. This can be removed. Need to be need to have a transition. This is probably going to take a while before this really is without errors. But it's reasonably simple though. We just want to run, tell SDN that if XDM dbus runs any of these programs, that it should just domain transition back to the XDM domain and just run it in the XDM domain. And that way, should become a little bit cleaner. Jesus Christ. Okay, whatever. It's pissing me off. It's just pissing me off. Seems I need to put this all the way down. Seems that. Still unknown type. So that wasn't even, that wasn't actually it. In a class process. Class process, and I'll just make that a transition. a little bit dark. Syntax error. Glass process transition. Man, oh man, it's not. Oh, it's early to get all kinds of stupid typos. All right, at least loads now. And I'll just have to log out and see how this affects. Need to get that stuff straightened out. Now we're getting used to doing that. Logging in, logging out, and you know. So we are at 8:10. And then we're just now we're getting all these stupid entry points. So back to the MyXDM. Basically, we need the entry points for each and every one of these. Class file. But we're all just be patient and don't rush things again. At here where it connects to oh, this DM session worker actually, so that just needs to be allowed. Nice. All right, so we're actually locked out right now. Yeah, we are. Should actually add that to our script. RMRF 1012. Although that might cause some issues. It's pretty clean right now anyway. But we could at least well, actually we should just try that. Where is my script? Right. That's already some time ago. Run user team 1012. RM RF run user 1012. Okay, let's just try and log in again and then see what GDM still has to bark. We did I actually install it? Yeah, I probably did. Yeah, I did. So let's log in. So basically we're almost already an hour away and we haven't achieved all that much. But well, that's part of the job. Need to do some cleanup. These are normal. Although XDM and this one, looks a little weird, but most of these are just normal. And we should basically just do that with a type attribute. Grab sock file. See what's happening here. So num session trying to create a sock file with type xdm temp t. There's no I know because it's yet to be created. 6.5. Oh, then later on it's actually doing something with that sock file. No, it's not. Yeah, probably. Probably in temp. XDM temp T. Yeah, there's a lot of AT&T's here. Yeah, this one here. It's trying to create some sock files, yeah. Let's just see how this is dealt on my system. Whether that's done with a type transition or not. No, that's not done with a type transition. That's just basically allowed. Alright. So that makes, or that at least explains something about the design decisions. So we're back. So basically I'm just going to log out and in once again and just make sure that these XEM transitions are dealt with and leave it at that in that episode just to make sure that that works. Of course it's going to hang because it's set time again. This is 8020, so I'll make 8019 and then just pipe it into audit allow. Audit to allow. See, we still have some stuff that needs to be taken care of. This nano. My XDM T and just append that. Make that just so that we get these domain transitions out of the way. Basically that's basically what we did in this episode was basically make sure that XDM debugs the domain transitions on these various types that it various files that it executes so that we don't have to adjust the policy that much. All right, so it installed. Let's log out once again. Oh, log in actually and then log out again. So now we're at 22, so I'll make that 21. See if we have some XDM execute related permissions. These are all just things that I expected. I'm just looking for execute right now, not for these. These are all expected. I'm fine. So no. There's none, so that's fine. Okay, log out for the last time. And do it once again, but then for 2023, I guess. Now let's make it 2 just to be sure. Any exec takes. I should just grab for exact though. But there's no exact, so we're super clean right now. So that's basically ends this chapter.